I have this NT530 Foxwell code reader, and I want to add another car. So you see, it's already came with Volvo, and I want to add a second car. You can add up to three cars here. Here's how it goes. You need to first go on internet. You need to just check my first video when I show how to set it up. So this is not to set it up initially, just to add another car. Check the first video first, because you need to download the software, which is called Fox Assist, and I show in that video where to download it. You need to install it on your computer. So to add another car, you need to go on foxwelltech.com on internet. So you need to just type in foxwelltech. I apologize about filming with the camera. My screen is just makes it a little bit easier for me for this time. So go on this site. They have many sites, Foxwell company. It's confusing where to go, what to get. And this site, it tells you that you need to check your code reader number. There are other models, and they have two websites where you need to go to update these things or to add things to them. It depends on the code number. So if you have the code reader NT650, you need to go foxwelltech.com. My NT530, I need to go on foxwelltech.us. So that's not the same thing. So let's just click here for my one, the one that I have. Click on foxwelltech.us. It's going to bring you to this place where you actually can see what you have, actually your product. It'll show you the your code reader here. You need to log in with your email and account that you set for Foxwell. See the other video. So on the left side here, if you click, you'll find registered products. It'll show you what I have, the 530. But if you scroll down here, you have this button, software renewal package. Click it. And in a few moments, it will show you all the available cars, car brands, because you don't add just the car model, you add the entire brand. So it shows you what car you want to, actually you need to pick one. Let's just say I'm going to select Subaru. So what happens is that you click here on buy button, and what happens is that you only, I'm not showing you right now, but the only way to pay this, by the way, the price is usually $60 for a single car brand additional to the original one. So when you pay for this, actually you can only pay with PayPal. I could not find a credit card or something like that, only PayPal. Bear this in mind, not everybody, I guess, has PayPal, so bear this in mind. It will take several days before you receive the files, and you can go back on this site, and perhaps I don't know exactly, because I didn't order another car yet. Maybe look at the registered products, see if you have anything new arriving here. But what I also suggest is check the software. So this is the software, it's not internet, it's just standalone software installed on my computer. Come back to Fox Assist here. And actually, when you want to work with the software, you need to plug in the code reader. There's two things I want to mention. First, you need to connect it to you, obviously, with the USB cable. And because in my first video I did mention to make a copy of the SD card, so because the Chinese SD cards that this come with get corrupted and you lost everything, so make a copy for that card. But when you update the code reader and you want to connect it with the software, you absolutely need to use the original SD card. So don't discard it. Put it at some safe place and use it when you update the code reader. Whenever you want to download anything else, use the original SD card, not the copy. The copy is not going to be recognized. So insert the original card and then go to this screen, and you have the update button. navigate to it and just click enter or the center button. This will put it in update mode, and after a few seconds you will see your file appearing, let's see, I don't need this, in the download section here, tab. So these are my files. I do have one card, the original one. When you will receive the new car, which was, I think I did select Subaru, let's say, I think, but I just cannot be sure because I never did it, I think the files will appear here for the second car or extra car, extra model, extra brand, not just one car, right? It's a brand. So the files should appear here, in my opinion. If you have a different experience, just let us know in the comment section. So come back every day here. It may take several days, maybe 1 week sometimes, before you can see these files here. So the software should be connected through internet, and Foxwell should put into your software here the new files, I think. So this will be the way to verify when you receive the file. Once you receive those files, be sure to have obviously the code reader connected in the update mode. You'll just click the update button. It's going to actually update all the files, the older one, the newer one. It's even going to update the file for the software itself. Notice this is the name of the software because this is the file for the software. So you'll see here downloading, then you'll see unzipping is going to be red, and some point it's going to turn green when it's finished. However, you will get a pop-up message or pop-up window here saying turn off the software to complete the installing or so. Don't touch that pop-up window until everything here is green, the old, the new file, except this one. This one will stay red because this is the one that you will finish installing the last. So when you see everything here green except for the first line, which will be red, then only then click yes or just close this software, and that will complete installing the new version of the software. But don't close it or don't click on that pop-up window before everything else is green here, because that will stop the installation for some of the files here. So that's just the last step to complete the update of FoxAssist software on computer. I hope this is how it's going to work. If you have a different experience, let us know in the comment section. Be sure to check my first video, and also in the first video I did put a comment, I did pin a comment, so the top comment, scroll down into that comment, I put a ton of information, even a contact email for helping from the company and so on. So check out the, by all means, that video, which I am going to put in the comment section, top of it, on this video too. I'm going to link that video in the comment section. Thanks for watching.